This summer, one man, one computer, in the ultimate test of time.
Arnold, I don't think there's any chance we're gonna get these exports done in time.
You gotta just trust in the settings, my dude.
Arnold Schwarzenegger is... the exporter.
I feel like these intros are getting weirder and weirder. What's going on, guys? My name is Chris Out, and in this week's video, welcome to the premiere of the ultimate export settings for crispy 4K video. All right, so with the latest update to Adobe Premiere Pro, we are seeing drastically better performance and quicker export times. The reason why this is happening is because software companies like Adobe are talking with hardware manufacturers like Nvidia so that all their software and hardware works together effectively. And the whole goal is so that creators like you and I have a better user experience. So if you guys are not running the latest version of Premiere Pro, make sure you guys are updating that right now. Now you guys need to make sure that you have the right settings and hardware to take advantage of this latest update. So if you guys are on a PC like I am, let's jump into this. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna press Control Alt Delete. Now you're gonna go into your task manager and you're gonna go over to the performance tab. At the bottom, you'll see your GPU. Now click on that and see what GPU you're running. In this case, we are running an NVIDIA 2080 Ti. Now our PC is custom built, it's a beast. So as long as you guys have an NVIDIA graphics card that's above 1050, you're gonna see faster and quicker exports as well as just like general better performance in Premiere Pro. Now to get a little bit more technical as to why this is all happening, this is due to NVIDIA's NVENC encoder, which literally stands for NVIDIA encoder. What's new about this is not only does it support H.265 exports, but it also supports GPU accelerated exports. Prior to this update, the only time the GPU was actually being used was during the editing process. So you'd be like working, you'd be editing, you'd have better performance there. But when it actually came to exporting these files, it would only rely on the CPU. So that's where like the big bottleneck would happen. Now with the latest update, it's taking advantage of the GPU, which is far more powerful. And that's why we're seeing faster exports. Okay guys, now that that is all out of the way, let's finally jump into Adobe Premiere Pro and make sure that we're optimizing all of these new features. Now first thing that you're gonna want to do is go into File, then Project Settings, then General. From that drop-down menu, you're gonna wanna go in and select Mercury Playback Engine GPU Acceleration in brackets CUDA and hit OK. Now you're gonna wanna go to Edit, Preferences, Media, and then you're gonna wanna make sure Enable Hardware Encoding and Decoding is checked. So here's our timeline. We have three clips on it. We have a 4K 30 frame per second clip. We have a drone clip in here that is 4K, and we have one 1080p upscale to 4K slow motion clip. Now all of these clips have been graded using Premiere Pro's Lumetri Color. And one of the things I wanted to point out is if you go to the effects panel and you look up Lumetri Color, you'll notice this little icon right here. That is a GPU accelerated clip, which essentially means that your GPU is gonna handle this. Now let's go ahead and set our in and out points on the timeline. And now we're gonna hit Control M on PC or File Export Media, and this will bring up the export dialog box. Now for format, we're gonna choose H.264 from the drop-down menu. Now this is the most popular codec, although H.265 is definitely coming up. Now you're gonna wanna make sure you have export video and export audio checked, unless you're just exporting like a silent film and you're making silent films and that's your thing. So then I guess you could save yourself one step by clicking just video. But 9 times out of 10, you're probably gonna have both of them checked. Now we're gonna go down to these tabs here. So let's start with video. Now for basic video settings, we can always select match source because we already have that set up in our timeline. All right, you'll see some other options here. Field order, progressive, aspect, square pixels. Just leave that as is. Unless the square pixel says anything lower than 1. Rendering at maximum depth is not always necessary, but when you're working with 10-bit color or doing a lot of color grading, then you'll definitely wanna have this selected. Now the only reason I wouldn't select this is if you're in a hurry. If we hover over it, we can actually see that this option will slow down your encoding time. Now move to encoding settings. This is the key step. For performance, we wanna make sure that we have hardware encoding enabled. Now, if you hover over it, you can see that it specifically tells us that it'll be using NVIDIA's available hardware to accelerate the encoding process. Now, if this option is grayed out for you, you either have some other settings on like VBR 2-pass that disables hardware encoding, or you just don't have a compatible GPU. For profile, you wanna choose high, and for level, you wanna choose 5.2. Now scroll down to bitrate settings. This is also super important. If you drop down, we have three options: CBR, VBR 1-pass, and VBR 2-pass. Now, like I mentioned earlier very briefly, VBR 2-pass will disable hardware encoding, so we're gonna eliminate that option for now. All right, we're gonna talk about bitrate before we start. Hey Chris, question. You're gonna do the shout out here, right? You're gonna have my handles. Pinterest logo and the Etsy logo, so they follow me. Thanks, buddy. All right, let's talk about bit rates. So CBR stands for constant bit rate. So when you set your bit rate, it's gonna remain consistent throughout the whole export. The next option is VBR pass one, which stands for variable bit rate. And then it's gonna look through that the entire video and it's gonna decide which part of the video requires higher bit rate. So let's say you have an area that you put a lot of graphics into, that could be a high bit rate. And then imagine Bill just talking on camera with his beautiful mustache, that could be a low bit rate. Now what you'll see next is VBR two, which stands for variable bit rate two pass. It goes through it once and then it's double checking its work and it's going through it again. And what we'll see is that it takes literally twice as long for marginally better video quality. And that's your technical education session. Make sure to follow me on Etsy. Now, obviously you want the highest quality possible in the least amount of time. So we're gonna go with CBR. Now we wanna set our target bit rate. YouTube has this handy little guide that helps us determine the right bit rate for our video settings. Keep in mind, YouTube is still gonna compress this video even after you've set it to 35 to 45. So what we wanna do in this case is we're gonna set it to 65 so that after YouTube compresses that video, it still looks crispy, it still looks delicious, it still looks like another analogy that's related more to food. A quick reminder though, that when you set it to 65 bit rate, it will increase your file sizes, but if you guys have the storage for it, I would recommend that you set it to 65. So the only thing left to do is decide whether or not we want to render at maximum quality. When we hover over this option, it tells us again that it will increase the encoding time. The reason why we're choosing this is because we often mix 1080 120 frames per second footage with 4K footage in our timeline. Now choosing this option will render the upscale footage at the best quality possible. Little hot tip, to save this as a preset, just come back up to this little icon beside the preset option and click save preset. Give it whatever name you like Chris, this took way too long to get through and I'm glad I actually have this preset now. Now hit okay, and you guys are all set to export your video. So that's it, everybody. That's how we export our 4K videos. If you guys actually want to save some time and download that preset, links are below. And on that note, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Thank you so much, NVIDIA, for sponsoring this week's episode. If you guys saw some value in this, please press like. It's right down there. Oh, hey, like button. What's going on? You guys can also drop a comment if you have any other questions regarding exporting or technical questions for Bill. He will be jumping into the comment section as well. And on that note, I love you guys. Peace out. Hit the bell. All that other jazz. I'll go get Bill. I think he has something he wants to tell you guys. I don't want to forget this moment. I always get so excited when I'm on Chris's channel. Smile, please. Bigger. I'm gonna put that one up in my living room. I'm thinking about starting a daily vlog. That's so boring. Everyone always does a daily vlog. You know what? I'm gonna be the first to do hourly vlogs. 24 videos a day, 7 days a week. First video, my handy cam collection. Go and find it. Bill out from Bill Cinematic Productions. Peace out, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for watching. Don't forget the Pinterest and Etsy logos. Wow! Bill here to talk about bit rates. One of my favorite things in the whole world. Which rate should we go? Always with bit rate.